Inside these gates, here in Shanghai, is a very valuable piece of property. It's home to the Shu Area Village, number 2. This residential community is literally across the street from the Expo Park, and the people who live here have had a front row seat to witness the birth of the China Pavilion.
Nice
view.
很开心啊，个很好，对吧？
阿拉环境老好啊，小区环境、外头环境侪老好啊。Long, long time for that.
The view out of this window is nothing but spectacular. That, of course, is the China Pavilion. But it is this view out of this window that tells a very different story of the China Pavilion. I'm Nancy Merrill. The first thing you see when you enter the park and the last thing you see when you leave it is the China Pavilion. Mao Juchen is the deputy director of the China Pavilion Department in the Bureau of the Shanghai World Expo. She has a strong academic background in city development and planning and understands best what the China Pavilion will bring to the city.
That's true.
How do you see the juxtaposition of the China Pavilion and the city of Shanghai?
As you can see, Shanghai is a very much westernized city. You see a lot of Western-style architecture, the Bund, for example. And nowhere else in Shanghai can you see an architecture like China Pavilion. And that's the reason why we chose it. And here you see our emphasis on tradition and our cherishment of the tradition. So we want to have this balance.
In December 2007, the construction of the China Pavilion began. And the Shuye Village number 2 began its own metamorphosis. Wei Min has been living in this village for more than 20 years. As a photographer with several decades of shooting experience, he has developed a trained eye, and so he notices and captures the changes in daily lives. From the photographs of Wei Min, the unusual relationship between the people of Shuye Village number 2 and the China Pavilion have been captured.
That几年功夫以后，世博会一起来，它就是一个顶级的一个市中心了，就是。这个变化是很巨大的，而且不仅是这种叫社会地貌的变化，而且整个人的生活、人的关系。 它都会起一个很大的变化，所以从2004年开始就开始拍，就是用老百姓的眼睛看我们的中国馆。我看了呢，就这个角度呢，就这四个角，那拍肯定漂亮呀。Zhao
Jinzhe is the chairperson of the residence committee of the Shuye Village. In China, the residence committee is one of the neighborhood organizations whose function is to help manage the community. It is a nexus of the social relationships.
为什么称为世博第一村呢？它有两个含义，一个就是在我们当时动迁的时候呢，有5个居民区，4个都已经动迁了，唯一留下的就是徐家村，还有一个就是我们中国馆的储藏馆，靠近我们最近的距离。 仅150米左右，因为世博它有个阳光动迁，所谓的阳光政策是什么呢？就是说，一般情况下就是拆一还二田区这样一个模式，还有考虑到户口啊、居住的环境啊等等。In
line with the relocation project, the residents of 4 other villages have chosen their new houses. They've signed the papers, wrapped up their luggage, and they're on their way to a new chapter in their lives.
中国馆的原址是雪野山村子，是个老的老公房的一个新村。这它主要就是雪野山村，这雪野一村就做停车场和那个广场了。这个地方就是雪野山村，雪野一村拆了，雪野山村拆了，就留下雪野二村，就这样。
According to Zhao Zhenzhi, his village is the only one left behind. He said it was due to financial limitations of the local government.
当时我们一些居民还是应该说，他们本来对动迁的希望还是比较大的，所以那个当听说雪野二村最后是没有划入动迁的范围，部分居民确实有些心态失衡。
Herr Jingtang is the main designer of the China Pavilion.The conceptual oriental crown promoted by his design team faced twists and turns all along the entire proposal phase. Taking part in the competition first, being judged and chosen, then losing the election, and finally being picked for the project. Even the process of choosing the exterior color of the pavilion has encountered untold setbacks.
为了这个红色，我当时最担心。我们从2008年8月份开始成立一个顾问委员会研究，后来等到定红的过程中，又请了中国美术学院的色彩研究所宋教授参加一起研究。
啊，这些收集的图库，哪个颜色比较好？这个太粉了。哦，大概是2009年3月11号吧。哦，那天去的，我被通知到现场之后，看到巨大的那个铁架子，哦，心理压力是比较大的。应该说，我估计在看到15分钟这一段时间，从1分钟到15分钟，其实眼睛是茫然的，就不知道该怎么办的。
For about half an hour, Professor Song Zhengning was standing under the cement structure of the China Pavilion in silence.After getting an impression of this huge task, Professor Song met Ding Hao, the deputy chief of the Expo Bureau, to negotiate the time frame of this challenging project.
然后那个丁局长问我，说是宋院长，你看多长时间可以拿出？啊，我算了一下，我要求2个月的时间。我谁知道我这个话音未落，他马上就说不行，不可以有这么长时间。然后我说那多久呢？至少1个月。他不行的，1个星期。我当时非常惊讶，就是1个星期怎么可能拿得下来？啊，然后我就跟他讨价还价，讨成了2个星期。啊，最后他是勉强同意2个星期。按照秩序，按照秩序，按色系。被像扑克牌一样散开。
But you know, look, this red, for instance, that red. How would you compare that to the Chinese red?
哦，它和中国红还是很接近的，但是中国红呢，它还有自己的特点，它比较厚实，比较温厚，有自己的民族特点。
And so I noticed also.What are these hats doing up here?
哦，这是安全帽。
That's your hat.
就是进工地的时候。
That's the one you wore when you snuck in. Let me see how you looked. Pull it down. Okay.
就这样。
Very nice. Migrant worker up at top.
早期的时候啊，他们对就戴着民工帽子的上班的工人，就是。上班工人就跟着上班的工人一起进去，你就大概6点多吧，就是一面吃东西一面戴个民工帽，哗就进去了。那么还有呢，就是从别的地方，比如说跳墙啊、钻洞啊，都能进去。但是后来就查的比较严了。
Where'd you get the hat？
头盔就是在工地上捡的呀，就在一个他们的一个车间里面。就工人废弃的，一个安全帽把它擦擦干净，头上一扣，不来管理了。但是到了世博会后期， 建设后期的时候，他管得很严了，这是有那个电子卡，这戴安全帽都不管用了，这就要用别的办法进去了。
100 meters away, the construction of the China Pavilion had been pushing forward, and the residents of the Shuye Village No. 2 knew they were destined to bear the most difficult times as the historical event proceeded.
而且这居民心里还特别不平衡，就是，动迁没人到，他呢就是学野一层动迁掉了，学野三层动迁掉了，就留下这一块。它是这么凸出来的一块，像个半岛形的。
这是我们辖区周边那个频繁的那个土方车进出的时间，就是28秒钟一辆，这是经过掐算的。那可想而知，这个扰民的现象应该说也是非常非常厉害的。
灰尘啊，就是停电停水啊，饭烧了一半，饭就加生了，没办法烧了，经常性的。
有一户居民，他这个吊灯都掉下来，还有那个水管都弯掉。
刚刚洗完洗澡，还没冲呢，这水就没有了。
但是这些呢，就是老百姓呢，开头应该说他有一个适应的过程。
Besides the numerous disturbances brought by the construction of the Expo Park and the China Pavilion, the residents of Shuye also felt uncertainty about their future. Meanwhile, in order to match the external appearance of the China Pavilion and the Expo Park, a renovation project of Shuye Village No. 2 was started.
最痛苦的吧，也可以说，就是那个每天上班时间是没规定的。比如说我们正常的上班是8点半，一般情况下我们上班就要7点多一点就要上班了，要接待老百姓。因为特别是整新工程这一段时间，每天30-40个人次，应该不说是很正常的。那有人跟我开玩笑，你这里像医院看门诊一样排队，这也不为过，因为确实的，因为整新工程一辆的矛盾比较多。因为涉及1800多户居民，这个矛盾协调应该说是非常那个难度是非常大的。
Despite the huge problems encountered in their respective work, Zhao Jianzhe, as well as Professor Song, stepped up to the challenges and somehow always managed to come up with solutions. The opening ceremony of the expo was less than 1 year away.And yet the color of the China Pavilion's new gown was still undecided. Meanwhile, the Shuye village was also expecting its new outfit in the form of their renovation project.
我搿趟哪能得出身啥人？
我后头越打好，我一听勿对啊！我明明只拖好，哪能外头里头哗啦哗啦水啦？搿么哗啦哗啦水，我认为我自家还没弄清爽，我要去看一看勿啦？一看勿对啊！伊诚心拍个水伐？那我现在呀，我要拿伊叫出来不啦？我肯定还问伊个问明白了。
就是讲，该阿拉名字条件出来的，侬就应该行阿拉，因为迭个事体，侬拿事体经过。
And as a result, Zhao Jianzhe found that he was facing even more problems.
对吧？因为名字条件呀，大家要上。因为第二呢，住了一道，邻里之间，抬头不见低头见。在整新工程中，有部分居民还也不是很配合理解，因为考虑到。地理环境，他们对那个动迁还是抱有一定的奢望，但是随着整新工程的开始，那个动迁的可能性就不存在了，一部分居民的心态可能失衡了，所以对我们后期的一些整新工程带来一定的阻力。
It must have been very hard for you with all the people coming and complaining.
确实也比较累，但是那个看到小区整个的氛围都这么好，世博会办得这么成功。受到了国际友人的一致认可，我感到很高兴，也很欣慰。从内心感到，我付出应该是值得的。
曹书记呢，非常非常的忙，很多时间呢，他还要接待我们的一个就是居民，比如说有一些大大小小的事情，反正居民嘛，就总相信居委会。到居委会来呢，就必定要找他，像把他当成自家人一样，有什么问题呢，都会来跟他联系。
The people of the village were still trying to be optimistic about their future.While outside their gates, their nearest neighbor, the China Pavilion, was entering its final stage, and its future unveiling was imminent. The deadline for the last draft is around the corner, but Professor Song and his team still haven't found the perfect red color.
这个绝对眼睛又发绿了。其实差不多在2个星期过去的时候， 没有一个颜色让我感觉安静。换句话说，都不对。啊，那个时候大概几百个颜色已经出来了，啊，嗯，然后其实很急的。
我们把第一个总的一个要求，就是希望这个颜色很正、很大气，表现了中国一种经典红色。
这幅好，这款是不是好一点？为什么是中国红？哦，在儒家的里头，五方正色里头还有四个颜色，合不合适？啊，比如说青黄赤黑白，所以我们其实一一做过比较的。只有中国红的时候，所有人心都很踏实。那说明它只有一个解释。一般的人，建筑师就不敢用红颜色，因为用完以后心给人造成心理压力很大。
因为红的，通常红的很小的才很好看，这么大的红。屋顶呢，我们那个宽度啊是140米乘140米，两个半足球场这么大，搞不好很耀眼，还有很跳，或者是不协调。
哦，这个大家可能有这种生活中有这个体会，一看阳光下一张红纸，哦，你只要看到5秒钟以上，那个绿斑就开始浮出来了。时间越久，这个绿斑是越厉害，啊，所以建筑的话，这么大的体量，是一般不太敢用这样的红颜色的。
The Forbidden City, with its magnificent ancient structures, looks like it's literally saturated in the color red.
但事实上，从色彩专业的角度看，它不是一个颜色的，它是由一个颜色组群构筑起来的。
The magnificent composition of the various red colors in the buildings of the Forbidden City has become the source of Professor Song's inspiration.
不同的民族实际上对各种各样的色彩，它有自己的定义，啊，跟中国不完全一样，但是呢，有一部分是重叠的，啊，但是应该说，世界上所有的这些民族、人类的这些民族的话，对红颜色的痴迷，中国人是达到最高峰，大概。
The connection between the color red and the culture of China has its own history, one that stretches back to ancient times, and even today, that red still has a strong hold on the lives of Chinese people.
我其实内心已经开始有点急了，所以那天我就跟他讲，干脆用传统的办法吧，就是用油画布、画刀、油画颜料，用手调。哎，我这个其实就把它变成一张画了。我想你是不是准备想拿去拍卖是吧？刷了大概有一两个小时吧，哦，把那颜色折腾过来折腾过去，因为调来调去的，最后发现有一组颜色开始浮出来的时候，我心里其实有点激动的，我觉得找到了。土黄可能太凶了。
Professor Song describes 7 especially harmonious red colors. They're divided into 2 groups.4 have been used on the outside and 3 on the inside. They blend so perfectly that the human eye can't discern one from another. And so the original aim of the designer, which at times seemed impossible to achieve, has come true.
这个就是，也就红色的基地牌的这个滚涂线。
I've learned that red is more than just a color, more than a pigment, more than a paint.
实现了，一个现你现在看都站在家门口啊，这是我们那个建筑门口，就感觉到。哇，一个样样大国，我们中国，这个我们中华民族崛起吧，人们感到自豪自信，有这样一种场所感，就是很把中国文化这种非常特有的特色，通过这个建筑牌表现出来。 但是这个表现不是很具象的。
We are trying to match the traditional Chinese wisdom with the latest trends of development.
就因为它不高嘛，后面如果是蓝天的话，这个红的很跳。邻居对中国馆，有的是很喜欢的。这是中国传统嘛，对吧？一个大红的，对吧？像个大礼包一样的，对吧？就是它这个红颜色呢，红的非常鲜艳，非常热烈。
我们那个中国红大家都知道是中国人民传统以来都比较向往的这样一个颜色，那个世博第一称为什么这样叫出来，也是由于我们可以说老百姓说借中国馆的光吧。
出去我打的回来就靠近中国馆就到家了。
再说呢，就是现在这好像房价涨到25,000了吧，大伙儿说起来乐滋滋的，好像
因为这一块应该说些，不要说它房子涨价了，我出路很方便，无论乘公交车或者地铁，到哪都有。
而且觉得我们这个地区啊，整个好像档次上去了，就有这种感觉。
我从事社区工作已经12年了，那个亲眼目睹了整个小区的变化。由于世博会的召开，那我们整个辖区的面貌已经发生了很大的变化。每家每户呢，通过整新工程以后，显得格外的漂亮。有时候确实那个我有一种很自豪感。
And so for these residents, the red of the China Pavilion will be forever a close and constant reminder that they live next to a very special neighbor, one who has changed their lives. For them, one who is the Pavilion of Luck.
What's his name?
Hi. Oh, no, 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 I said, hello.
You are welcome.
Oh, I'm welcome. Thank you.
I'm great to see you.
谢谢 ，Look at us. Bye bye. Oh, hello.
Long after the expo is over, the China Pavilion will remain. It's China's gift to its people. It's China's gift to the world. I'm Nancy Merrill.